In this video, we'll present a wizard for the DeskProto CAM software, specially made for the Roland JWX-30 wax milling machine. This is a great machine for jewelers, as it solves the biggest problem that many jewelers have with their CNC machine, which is how to correctly and accurately set the workpiece zero point. This machine will set the zero point fully automatically. You can see that the machine touches the fixture from all sides in order to find its exact location. Note that when measuring, the cutter even makes half a rotation to compensate for a possible crooked cutter. You can see that rotation, yes, right now. Each Roland machine is delivered with the Roland SRP Player CAM software. This video will show the advantages of using the DeskProto CAM software instead. And the video will also show you how easy it is to create wax models on a low-cost CNC milling machine. Models with a superior surface quality in a wax type that has perfect casting characteristics. Let's start DeskProto. Okay, what we see now is the DeskProto welcome screen. One of the nice things in DeskProto is that it has custom wizards, called script wizard in previous versions. And these are made specially for some hardware, like here for the JWX-30 machine for wax ring machining. We want to use that one. Okay, as always, the first step in DeskProto is to load a geometry file. We will use the ring that is used by Roland as well, the Rhinogold tutorial ring. We open that geometry, it is loaded. And here you can see that it's not properly aligned with the cylinder shape that indicates the rotation axis direction for the ring. So that's a standard thing that we can fix. We need to rotate it 90 degrees around the Z axis. Here we go. Next wizard is a check. Are the dimensions correct? From 0 to outside is a radius of 14.5 millimeter. The orientation zero, the zero point is in the center, so that's all okay. We can press next. DeskProto has already checked for us that it fits in a small clamp. Okay, we have a series of wax blocks for the small clamp with a thickness of 12 millimeters. We make another check. Okay, the ring fits inside, so now I can use my next button for the next step, which is adding the support system, a core block and a few spokes. I'll use the standard values. If needed, I can change the length of the blocks and also the thickness, but I use them as default. Cutter to be used is a standard 1 millimeter diameter bullnose cutter as supplied by Roland by this machine, and I will also use the default values for toolpath distance, so a default accuracy. Next, DeskProto will create a number of parts. You can see it on the left side in the tree view. We'll show you there's one part for the first side, one part for the second side after the 180 degree flip, and a third part for the rotation axis machining. All done automatically, and next I can calculate the toolpath. That's also quite fast. 14 calculations have to be done, 14 operations are present. Two threads at the same time, I can show you. This is a dual core machine. When you have a multi core machine and also even a 64-bit version of Windows with sufficient RAM, this will go quicker, because on this small PC some swapping has to be done, which takes time. Now the toolpaths have been calculated, and so we can continue. Final screen of the wizard is either writing the 2NC files, but for this machine it's not needed, as we can send the files directly from DeskProto to the machine. First, quickly show them to you. Here is the several operations. I'll make the LUT invisible for you. So here is the roughing. After that come the contour lines, after that come the finishing, and after that some 2D stuff in order to drill the holes. Okay, make them all visible again. and as said, we can send them directly to the machine. However, obviously, first we need to prepare the wax block. Wax block in place, zero point has been set, so now we can send the current toolpath to the machine. DeskProto will remind me that operations in part 1 and 2 have been combined to one chain, including the 180 degree rotations, so that's okay for me. Just a warning, the machine needs to be in the correct status to receive the toolpath, so I can say send and it will start machining.
Thank you.
And here is the result. Conclusion is that DeskProto does not only calculate faster than SRP Player, the resulting toolpaths are far more efficient as well. You can try this for yourself, using your own geometries and your own Roland machine, by downloading the free DeskProto trial version. It is fully functional for a period of 30 days.